pain, suffering, pushing boundaries, the relentless pursuit of faster splits, higher heart rates, deeper exhaustion. This is the language of modern running culture. We glorify the grind, the lung-searing intervals, the lactate-flooded tempos. We chase the burn, believing that suffering is synonymous with progress. But what if I told you the single most important physiological threshold for your endurance success, the very foundation upon which all your speed and stamina are built, is the one you barely feel? The one that doesn't hurt? The one that looks boring, feels easy, and never makes it onto your Instagram highlights? I'm talking about your aerobic threshold, LT1. And the brutal truth is, your obsession with high-intensity training, your neglect of this fundamental marker, is likely the primary reason you are plateauing. It's the reason your marathon pace collapses, your recovery stalls, and your injury risk remains stubbornly high. You are building a performance skyscraper on a foundation of sand, focusing solely on the penthouse suite, your VO2 max and LT2, while ignoring the crumbling basement. In this masterclass, we are pulling back the curtain on the most misunderstood and criminally underrated metric in endurance training. We will dissect the science of LT1, expose why training below and around this easy threshold is the non-negotiable key to unlocking elite levels of fat oxidation, metabolic efficiency, and sustainable speed. Forget the no pain, no gain dogma. It's time to train smarter, not just harder. It's time to respect the science of your aerobic foundation. Music shifts, becomes more measured, scientific. Defining the foundation, LT1 versus LT2. Let's establish clarity. Most serious runners have heard of the lactate threshold LT2, often called the anaerobic threshold. This is the red line we discussed previously, the intensity where lactate production rapidly outpaces clearance, acidosis builds, and fatigue becomes overwhelming within minutes. Training at LT2 tempo runs is crucial for improving your ability to sustain high-intensity efforts. But LT1, the aerobic threshold, comes much earlier. LT1 is the first point during incremental exercise where blood lactate concentration begins to rise noticeably above resting baseline levels, typically around 1 millimole per liter above baseline, often landing near 2 millimoles per liter absolute. Think of it as the very first sign of metabolic stress. Below LT1, your body is operating almost purely aerobically, comfortably burning a mix of fat and carbohydrates with minimal lactate accumulation. At LT1, you cross a subtle boundary. Fat oxidation is still high, but carbohydrate utilization starts to increase more significantly, and lactate production begins its initial gentle climb. Physiological correlates. LT1 typically occurs around 65 to 75% of your max heart rate, HR max, or zone 2 in a 5-zone model. Perceived exertion, RPE. This is your true conversational pace. You can speak in full sentences comfortably without gasping. It feels genuinely easy. Contrast with LT2. LT2 occurs at a much higher intensity, 80 to 88% HR max, RPE 6 to 7, where conversation becomes difficult. There is a significant physiological gap between these two thresholds. LT1 is not dramatic. It doesn't burn. It doesn't scream for attention, which is precisely why most runners ignore it, blasting through this crucial zone during their easy runs, rendering them ineffective. Why LT1 is the bedrock of endurance? Science. Why should you care about this subtle, easy threshold? Because training at and predominantly below LT1 is the primary driver of the fundamental aerobic adaptations that define an endurance athlete. 1. Maximizing fat oxidation, becoming metabolically efficient. This is arguably the most critical benefit. Marathon running, even at elite paces, relies heavily on your body's ability to burn fat for fuel. Why? Because, as we know, glycogen stores are severely limited. The science, low-intensity training, below LT1, zone 2, preferentially utilizes fat as the primary fuel source. This consistent stimulus forces profound adaptations. Increased mitochondrial density, more power plants to burn fuel, increased fat transport, enzymes. Your body gets better at mobilizing fat from storage and transporting it to the muscles. Increased beta-oxidation enzymes. Your mitochondria become more efficient at the actual process of burning fat. The result? You become a fat-burning machine. Your respiratory exchange ratio, RER, the ratio of CO2 produced to O2 consumed, indicating fuel source, shifts downwards at any given submaximal intensity. This means you burn a higher percentage of fat and a lower percentage of precious glycogen, Research by Maunder et al., 2021, highlighted how elite marathoners exhibit superior fat oxidation rates, strongly linked to consistent, high-volume, low-intensity training. By maximizing your LT1 training, you are directly programming your body to spare glycogen and delay hitting the wall. 2. Building aerobic infrastructure, mitochondria, and capillaries. While high-intensity work can stimulate some mitochondrial growth, the most potent and sustainable signal for building a dense network of mitochondria and capillaries comes from prolonged, low-intensity exercise below LT1. The mechanism, easy running, creates a sustained demand for oxygen delivery and utilization over long durations. This triggers signaling pathways like PGC1-alpha that orchestrate the construction of new mitochondria and capillaries. The result, a denser network of power plants and fuel lines. Your muscles become incredibly efficient at taking up oxygen from the blood and using it to produce energy aerobically. This is the very definition of your aerobic base. A higher volume of zone 2 training directly translates to a bigger, more robust aerobic foundation. 3. Laying the foundation for intensity. This seems counterintuitive, but consistent training below LT1 actually makes your hard workouts better. Enhanced recovery. A strong aerobic base improves your ability to recover between high-intensity intervals and between hard workout days. Better oxygen delivery helps clear metabolic byproducts faster. Reduced stress. Training predominantly at low intensity minimizes overall physiological and nervous system stress compared to a high-intensity focused plan. This leaves you fresher and more capable of executing your key LT2 and VO2 max sessions with higher quality. Polarized training validation. This concept is the cornerstone of the polarized training model, rigorously studied by researchers like Steven Seiler. Studies like Seiler and Quarland, 2006, observed that elite endurance athletes across various sports perform approximately 80% of their training at low intensity, below LT1, about 5 to 10% at moderate intensity, around LT2, and 10 to 15% at high intensity, above LT2. This distribution consistently produces superior performance outcomes compared to models emphasizing large amounts of moderate intensity threshold work. Training easy allows you to train hard effectively. 4. LT1 as the key performance predictor. While VO2 max sets your ceiling and LT2 dictates your sustainable race pace for shorter events, LT1 is often the most reliable indicator of performance in long endurance events like the marathon. The rationale. Marathon pace for most runners sits in a zone above LT1, but below LT2. A higher LT1 pace means you can run faster for longer, while still relying heavily on efficient fat oxidation and minimizing lactate accumulation. It represents your sustainable all-day aerobic speed. The evidence. A comprehensive review by Faud et al., 2009, concluded that LT1, often termed the first lactate threshold in literature, is a highly reliable and valid marker for assessing endurance capacity and predicting performance, particularly in longer events. A higher LT1 speed directly correlates with a faster potential marathon time. Neglecting LT1 training is like trying to race a marathon fueled only by sugar packets. You'll burn bright, then burn out. Execution. How to train your aerobic threshold. Training LT1 isn't complex, but it requires discipline. The biggest challenge is resisting the urge to push harder, finding your LT1 zone, the easy zone. Heart rate, the most practical method, typically 65 to 75% of your HR max. If your max is 190, your LT1 zone is roughly 123 to 142 beats per minute. Use a chest strap for accuracy. Wrist-based HR is often unreliable. Rate of perceived exertion, RPE. It should feel like a 3 to 4 out of 10. You must be able to hold a full conversation comfortably without gasping for breath. If you can only speak in short sentences, you are likely above LT1. Pace. This will feel slow. It might be 60 to 90 seconds per mile, or 40 to 60 seconds per kilometer, slower than your marathon pace. Accept it. This is where the magic happens. Lab testing. A lactate test remains the gold standard for pinpointing LT1 precisely. Embrace the 80-20 rule. Dedicate approximately 80% of your total weekly running time to training at or below LT1. If you run 5 hours a week, 4 hours should be in this easy zone. This means your long runs, your recovery runs, and most of your filler mileage should be performed squarely within this low intensity range. Key LT1 workouts, the long run, 90 plus minutes performed entirely below LT1. This is the cornerstone of mitochondrial and fat adaptation development. Easy recovery runs, shorter runs, 30 to 60 minutes, performed at a very comfortable pace, low end of zone 2 or even zone 1, to aid recovery and add safe volume. Warm-ups and cool-downs. These should always be done at a very low intensity, contributing to your total zone 2 time. The fatal mistakes, why you're stuck. Why do so many runners fail to develop their aerobic threshold properly? Running easy. Runs too hard. This is the number one killer. Eager to feel productive, runners push their easy runs into the moderate intensity zone, between LT1 and LT2. This creates gray zone training. Too hard to be truly aerobic and build the base, but too easy to significantly raise LT2. It generates excessive fatigue with minimal specific benefit. Discipline is required to run truly easy. Insufficient volume, neglecting the overall weekly mileage, especially the long run. You cannot build a robust aerobic foundation running only 3 times a week for 30 minutes. Volume, predominantly easy volume, is essential. Obsession with intensity, prioritizing interval and tempo sessions while treating easy runs as an afterthought or skipping them altogether. This builds the roof before the foundation is laid. Ignoring data, failing to use heart rate or RPE to accurately stay within the target LT1 zone. Running based purely on pace without considering daily variations in fatigue or conditions. The aerobic threshold LT1 is the silent engine of endurance. It doesn't scream for attention like your VO2 max intervals or lactate threshold tempos, but it is the foundation upon which all sustainable speed is built. By dedicating the majority of your training time to this seemingly easy zone, you are performing the most profound, impactful work. Reprogramming your metabolism to burn fat, constructing a dense network of aerobic power plants, and building the resilience to handle higher intensities and longer distances without breaking down. Stop chasing the burn on every run. Start respecting the science of your aerobic base. This requires a plan that accurately identifies your LT1 zone and structures your training around it, balancing easy volume with precise intensity. This is where science meets practice. Our man-to-man coaching is designed for this. We analyze your data, potentially using field tests or lab results, to pinpoint your precise LT1 and LT2 zones. We build your personal polarized training plan, ensuring approximately 80% of your effort builds that crucial aerobic foundation. Using special software, we send workouts directly to your watch, guiding your intensity in every session. And with unlimited chatting, we monitor your progress, analyze your data, and make constant adjustments to maximize adaptation and keep you healthy. If you are ready to stop plateauing and start building a truly powerful, resilient endurance engine from the ground up, send me a message today. Positions are limited. Let's find your thresholds and build your breakthrough. Running Coach Demetris, Master of Science in Sports Science. Your running journey powered by science.